Hello everyone, this is a continuation of my first video, that is crystal field theory in transition metal complexes. We have already discussed about crystal field theory in octahedral complexes. Now we are going to talk about tetrahedral crystal field. What happens in tetrahedral crystal fields? None of the d orbitals point directly at the ligands as they did with the octahedral geometry, because in octahedral complexes dx square minus y square and dz square, these orbitals are lying across the axis and the ligands approach the axis directly, so their energy is higher up. While in case of a tetrahedral crystal field is a cube-like structure, what happens? The dxy, dyz and dzx orbitals lie along the plane, and then the ligand orbitals cannot come in close contact with the metal d orbitals. That's why what happens? Dxy, dyz, dzx orbitals feel more repulsion from the ligands, while dx squared minus y squared and dz squared orbitals feel less repulsion from the ligand. So where there is more repulsion, there is an unstable state, so the energy is higher. While in case of dx squared minus y squared, dz squared less repulsion, so energy lowered. So here, this is a crystal field in the tetrahedral complexes. This is exactly opposite to transition metal complexes. So when the ligands approach the metal ion in case of transition metal complex, tetrahedral metal complexes, the energy of the dxy, dyz, dzx orbitals increases, while the energy of the dx minus y square and dz square orbital decreases. The energy, the triplet state is called T2, whereas the doublet state is called E. Here it is not T2G or EG. Here G is not used because there is no central symmetry in case of tetrahedral complexes, while there is central symmetry in octahedral complexes. So G is used in case of octahedral crystal field. So in case of square planar complexes, what happens if you remove the ligands first from the z axis? So there will be only four ligands left in the metal plane. So ligand related with the z axis are completely removed outward, so there occurs the formation of square planar complexes. That's why the orbitals with the where z axis is involved will experience less energy from the incoming metal orbitals, so their energy will be incoming d orbital, sorry, so their energy will be lowered up, like dz square and dx y and the xz and dyz, they lie at the lower end of the series, whereas dx square minus y square and dxy, their energy is higher up. So this is the splitting in case of square planar complexes. So this is all we have to talk about octahedral crystal field, tetrahedral crystal field and the square planar complexes, where the d orbitals, that is their orientation, play a very big role in case of splitting of the d orbitals. Thank you.